Green, what are you doing? I was beginning to like you. Alright, so the last time we left off, Red and Green had the floppy disk with the information about Mew on it, and that's basically where we left off. Team Rocket had what they thought was a real floppy disk with all the information, and they kind of went their separate ways to some degree. This chapter is basically a big old brawl, for the most part anyways. It starts off with basically Green saying, well, Team Rocket's going to find out eventually that that's not the real disc that they wanted. So what she plans to do is sort of smart too, honestly, is to send her Ditto disguised as Mew. So that brings up a whole other question for me. Has she then seen Mew before? Like, Mew is this mysterious Pokemon that almost nobody's ever seen in their lives. So she must have seen Mew at some point in her life, and I guess maybe Ditto too, so that Ditto could transform into Mew without, like, any flaws, really. Either way, so she sends Ditto, Mew, off to distract Team Rocket once they find out that it's not a real disc that she gave to them. And in distracting them, Red and Green then go look for Mew. And I thought that she was going to be a good person. Come on. Like, okay, so her whole thing in the last chapter was that, like, I don't know, they were making it seem like, oh, she stole the disc from Team Rocket, so maybe she's not so bad. She's trying to protect Mew. But in reality, she just wants to sell Mew as, like, a pet to the richest person in the world. That's, like, so crappy. That's so shitty. Like, I can't even... Green... I thought I was gonna like her. Last chapter, she was so cool and nice, and like she was witty and cool and whatever. But like now she's showing another side. Like, she's still acting essentially the same, but like, now that we know her motive behind stealing the Mew disc, I don't like that. That's not cool. Red doesn't like it either, and it's just, it's a really weird situation that they're in, that Red is in, basically, with her. But yeah, anyway, so she takes out these goggle things. They kind of look like the self-scope? I don't know, it's the headgear thingamajigger. And she puts the floppy disk in, and apparently the best way to track down Mew, because obviously Mew is super hard to find, is to look for a certain kind of energy that psychic Pokemon give out. And every Pokemon's got its own specific kind of energy that it puts out. So using the information that was on the disc and putting it into these goggle things, they could track Mew. So basically that's what they do for the next like couple pages, where they see the trail, they go after Mew, they end up finding Mew, and I think this is where Red finds out that Mew is really her target because she wants to sell it for money. They end up going after Mew. Red basically captures Mew to some degree anyways. He has Ivy Storm Vine Whip grab Mew, and that's where the real battle starts. Team Rocket has shown up. They found out that Ditto was not in fact Mew, which is not that hard to find out eventually, because Ditto did not know any of Mew's attacks or abilities. So yeah, so that's like, as soon as Team Rocket figures that one out, they could just take out Ditto. But yeah, so they take out Ditto, they throw Ditto to Green, and they show up with their Jinx, and they start going out and all attack. At this point, Red and Green aren't like, kind of like stunned, they're trying to figure out what they can do to fight back. Red eventually kind of throws himself in front and says, take Mew and get out of here, because we can't let Team Rocket go. You get the feeling that he doesn't like Green's motives either. Right? You don't get the feeling. You know that he doesn't like Green's motives either, but he'd rather see Mew get away from Team Rocket than get into their hands, because then they'll use Mew to create the monster Pokemon that he saw in the lab. And they really show that he really does not like the idea of Mewtwo at this point. Like, I mean, I was talking about it in the last review that Mewtwo is kind of a tragic creature because it's a creation of science. It's kind of a Frankenstein Pokemon. But, like, Red really doesn't like Mewtwo at this point. He doesn't really even know about Mewtwo at this point. He only knows what he saw briefly when he was down there in their lab. And he is so against it at this point, even still. The creation of an unnatural Pokemon. And, he just doesn't want to see this come to fruition, I guess. So he'd rather see Mew, I guess, get sold off, than be captured and experimented on, which is a really cool thing. It's good. Red is, of course, the hero, so he's going to do what's right, ultimately, for the most part, anyways. Or at least do what he thinks is the best-case scenario. But yeah, so they battle, they're fighting out, he sends his Poliwrath out, but Poliwrath gets frozen, and Team Rocket basically has them on the ropes at this point. Mew then kind of takes action to some degree, and I don't know whether they stuns the Team Rocket member and Jinx, or whether it's just like, I got, one of the panels is weird, because it looks like they're like statues. So maybe Mew just, like, stunned them so, like, to stay still. But, like, Mew basically makes a giant flash of light, stuns them, and makes a beeline for an escape. End of the chapter is Mew got away, Team Rocket's gone, and while Red is kind of happy about that, Green is, like, sad because she didn't get her Mew, she's not gonna get her money from that. Boo-hoo. But she got a picture of Mew, so she could probably make a good amount of money off of that. She then makes a beeline for her escape to get away from Red, because obviously she doesn't need to be around him all the time. But she ends up leaving him with a note saying, "Thanks, sweetheart, for all your help," or whatever, and then leaves him his two badges. So that's the end of the chapter. I like this chapter. It was a battle chapter. There was some interesting stuff. The part that I really think I'd like the most is Red's hatred of the idea of Mewtwo, because they don't hammer it on too thick, but like they really touch on it, how like he does not like what Team Rocket is doing with that. He doesn't want anything to do with that, and he doesn't want it even to exist. He doesn't want anything like that to exist. And whether that's because he feels bad for Mew and Mewtwo, or whether he just thinks it's a gross a gross action that they're doing, and gene splicing, and, like, creating something that's, like, something that's against God's nature. Either way, we've always known this, but Red has a specific moral compass that guides him to help Pokemon, and once again, we see this. This chapter doesn't really have him be cocky at all. Like, honestly, over the last few chapters, he's kind of leveled out to a very certain degree, where he's still kind of like an idiot and whatever. Like, in a couple chapters ago, he was still bragging about how he has two badges and whatnot. But, like, ultimately, I think he's growing as a character slowly and steadily, and I'm really interested to see. I imagine the Team Rocket will eventually complete Mewtwo. Whether they get Mew or not, they will eventually complete Mewtwo to some degree, and that whole story arc will happen. I'm interested to see what Red's opinion of Mewtwo once it's finished is. Does he even capture Mewtwo? Probably not, honestly. I'm interested to see how Red reacts to a complete Mewtwo that has then is presumably escaped, or maybe is under control of Team Rocket. I'm really interested to see that. I want to see more of Green. Oh, listen, I have a love-hate relationship with Green. I love her, like, kind of snarkiness and wittiness, and, like, kind of, like, she's just very manipulative. It's kind of vindictive, too. But I do not like, I don't mind, okay, so money thing, fine. I can probably get around her being a con person to people, selling people bad, like, crappy stuff. But, like, the fact that she was gonna sell Mew, come on. Like, it'd be one thing if it was, like, kind of thing where it's, like, oh, she was gonna capture Mew. This is gonna sound bad either way, but, like, it'd be one thing if she was gonna capture Mew and then do, like, shows or something like that with Mew, and then collect money from that, I don't know. But, like, to sell off a Pokemon, like, that is one of the biggest taboos in Pokemon, generally. And to traffic Pokemon, that is not right in any capacity whatsoever. It's not right in the real world when people traffic animals. Although, I guess, technically, we do buy cats and dogs and, like, domestic animals. But, I don't know. That's a whole other thing, I guess. But Mew specifically is a legendary Pokemon. Mythical, I guess, technically. It's a one-of-a-kind Pokemon. And there's only one of it, as far as they know, in the world. So why would she feel like it's a good idea to sell it off? How could she morally do that? That frustrates me so much. Otherwise, I like her character, I guess. But yeah, I mean, those are my thoughts on this chapter. I don't really have much else to say other than that. Let me know what you guys think of this chapter down below in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed this chapter and what I had to say. Also remember to subscribe so you can keep up with future videos. I will see you guys in another video. Bye-bye. Have a good day.